Hello guys and welcome to another Bodysthenics tutorial. If you're new to our channel, be sure to start off by subscribing and hitting the bell icon for notifications so that way you don't miss any future videos just like this one. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you how to program your front lever training. In order to achieve a solid and perfect form front lever, we must train it consistently and methodically. It's not enough to just use trial and error and attempt random attempts in holding and expecting your form to improve or your holding times to increase. Hence why in today's video, we're going to show you how to train the front lever from all angles in order to increase strength in your scapula and your hips. Hence improve your form and progress much more safely and rapidly. Let's begin with your static holds. Once your training session starts, you must do your max hold attempts first. Regardless of what progression you're at, whether it's a tuck, half lay, or even full, you must work on building your holding time to at least 10 seconds before moving on to a more complex and challenging progression. Use up most of your energy towards attempting perfect form holds in the beginning of training when your mind and body is at its most optimal and when you are fresh. Once you are finished with your static holds, now it's time to do your static skills. A great go-to exercise is the support to front lever hold. This is where you spend time working on your front lever eccentrically, meaning that you are able to cheat the movement by establishing scapular retraction right from the support position and come down in an already engaged scapular position. Also, use a slight false grip once you come down, so that way you are able to recruit your forearms more efficiently into your static hold. Once you have fatigued from your static hold skills, now it's time to move on to your bent arm strength exercises. The first go-to exercise are the tucked front lever pull-ups. We recommend you use a false grip so that way your forearms are also recruited into the pulling motion. Eventually, over time, aim to get your knees further away from your hips to make the pulls a lot more challenging. The inverted rows are also effective after you have fatigued from the advanced tuck lever pull-ups. The same applies. Aim to maintain a horizontal torso along with the maintenance of a false grip. You can also combine your choice of progression of static hold with your choice of front lever pulls. This will further strengthen your hips and scapula. After the bent arm strength exercises, it's time to move on to your raises and negatives. It's wise to begin with your raises, seen as though the concentric phase is much more challenging than what the negative is. Raises can be performed in a full body position, in a half lay, by bringing your torso all the way up to the bar. And you can also perform half lever raises, where you come up to the horizontal line and back down with control. Using the rings is also effective, so that way you have more control of your grip in accordance to your strength level and your preference. You can also mix in the ice cream maker with your raises. This way your training adopts variety and complexity. Ensure that the focus with ice cream makers is the retracted scapula at all times. After the raises, it's time to move on to the negatives. The key with the negatives is performing low amount of reps with increased time and attention with a 6 second negative starting from the top candlestick position all the way to the bottom. And your primary focus must be to maintain the scapular retraction all the way down along with the glute engagement to ensure that your hips are in horizontal line at all times. Performing negatives in supersets with diverse progressions in one set is also extremely effective. 4 reps with a 6 second negative in each rep is very effective in building that time under tension and increasing the strength of your scapula. The tall ring setup is also a great choice when it comes to performing your negatives, so that way you are able to twist the rings and play around with certain grips. And finally, to end our session, we must condition ourselves with the appropriate reps. This is so that we condition our scapular retraction further. You can perform archer rows along with elevated rows and also pause explosive rows, which are all effective in building scapular strength and conditioning. The chest lift is also an effective exercise which really builds strength in your scapular region. Adding a pull-up makes the chest lift a lot more complex and challenging. And to end your session, perform regular hanging scapular depressions to release any tension that is built up in your shoulders from training and to further condition yourself for optimal front lever performance and rehab. And as we've mentioned in previous tutorials, every calisthenics training session must end with your choice of core exercises, ranging from hip thrust exercises on the bar and on the rings, combining them with leg raises, and of course, the most ultimate core exercise in calisthenics, the dragonflies.
Bodysthenics.
Thanks for watching today's tutorial, guys.
If you guys found value, then be sure to subscribe and also hit that bell icon for notifications. We upload a new tutorial every Wednesday and Saturday at 3 p.m. European Eastern Summer Time.
For those athletes who want a more in-depth approach to their calisthenics progress, be sure to get your own copy of the 100 Calisthenics Secrets book. And for an even more depth analysis on how you can progress as an all-round calisthenics athlete, be sure to get access to our exclusive Ultimate Calisthenics course. And for those athletes who want to join the Bodysthenics global family of athletes who are taking their skills and strength to the next level, be sure to apply for online coaching today in order to fast track your progress and achieve elite calisthenics status. I'm George, Bodysthenics coach. See you guys in the next video.